Learning Blender has been one of the most fun and enjoyable hobbies I have picked up in the last few years. I love discovering new things that this 3D application can do and honing my skills with new projects. Now, one topic I've actually become incredibly invested in is character animation. But as many people already experienced in character animation will tell you, it is hard. That's why as I've been experimenting with animation, I've become so much more interested in motion capture technology. I love the simplicity of it. I mean, someone just acts out the movements that you want your character to do, and then those movements are transferred onto your model's skeleton. Unfortunately though, proper motion capture setups are massive. They require their own rooms, tons of cameras, and special software to work. And like 99% of people on planet Earth, I cannot afford that. Luckily, as time has gone on, however, consumer-grade motion capture solutions have made their way onto the market, like the Rokoko suit. It's a pretty neat system, and instead of relying on arrays of cameras like big Hollywood motion capture studios typically do, the Rokoko suit instead uses accelerometers and IMU sensors to capture motion data at 200 frames a second. We're not gonna do that. Now, sure, $4,000 is a lot cheaper than the tens of thousands of dollars an actual motion capture setup would cost. But $4,000, for my purposes, is still way too expensive. And it's also completely unnecessary. So if I were going to do motion capture on the cheap, I'd have to continue my search elsewhere. And as my luck would have it, I'd actually discover my answer in the most unlikeliest of places. VR chat. For those of you who don't know, VR chat is a virtual reality hangout platform where users can upload their own custom avatars and worlds and then chat with their friends using these creations. A big part and the appeal of VR chat is the ability to express yourself with movement, which is why some users have invested in full body tracking solutions like Vive trackers. But Vive trackers are also expensive, which is why some people who want this experience have moved to an older and cheaper alternative, the Kinect.
Oh, brother!
So the Kinect came out right around the same time as the Wii, and it was designed to make you the controller. Essentially, the Kinect would track your body, and then using the position of your hands, your feet, and your body, it would use that as inputs for video games. Microsoft invested a ton into the Kinect, even going so far as to release a dedicated version for Windows and a second generation version on Xbox One. But unfortunately for them, gamers just never got really interested in the Kinect. Despite its failure in the gaming market, I realized this might actually be exactly what I was looking for. Think about it, it's a device that is capable of tracking human motion. There's a Windows SDK and software available online to capture that data and save it. And the best part? This thing only cost me $20. So to get motion capture data from the Kinect into Blender, I'm using a couple things. Firstly, obviously I'm using an Xbox 360 Kinect plugged into my computer. I'm also utilizing a program called Brekel Body to record my skeleton data into an FBX file. Additionally, I've got the Rokoko Studio add-on enabled in Blender, which will allow me to retarget my animation to any other armature I import into Blender. In this case, I've got my favorite Valorant character, Omen, thrown into the project file just for fun. I like him. He's a great guy. So I opened up Brekel Body, got into position, set up the recording, and did a quick wave to test it all out. Once I was done recording, I just imported the FBX into Blender, set up the two skeletons in Rokoko, and press retarget. Oh. Oh, what is, what? Oh. Oh, that's not good. So the results that we got were not as expected. In fact, all of the early testing I performed didn't have promising results. At first, I believed it was all because of the Kinect, because, to be honest, I was never going to get perfect results out of the Kinect anyways. The Kinect is capable of tracking up to 20 joints, which is plenty for my purposes. But it's capturing this data in a 640 by 480 video feed running at 30 frames a second. And because the Kinect relies so heavily on line of sight, if I were to do something as simple as take my arm and put it behind my back, it wouldn't be able to track my arm anymore. Much like how in film, when you overexpose an image, you can't just pull it back in post. Same thing applies here. You can't get motion data from something the sensor can't see. And lastly, due to the field of view on this thing, I have to stand all the way back at the end of my room to have this thing even accurately track me. And I am tall. The space I have to move around in is limited. This puts some heavy restrictions on the type of motion I can do and capture out of it. I don't know, perhaps I was too optimistic about how the Kinect would perform. I mean, this is how it was debuted to the public.
You ever wonder what the bottom of an Avatar shoe looks like? Well, bam, there it is.
As I was thinking about this though, I realized that none of this mattered in this case, and that it probably wasn't the Kinect's fault. I realized that in Brekel Body, the capture feed looked clean. Don't get me wrong, there was some noticeable jitter and mistakes, but it certainly didn't look like that. That's when I realized my issue was with retargeting. In Rokoko, I was using the rest option, which, because of how Omen looks in his rest position, was basically trying to match a T-pose to an A-pose. By moving Omen's arms into a T-pose manually and then selecting current, I got a very close match to what I originally expected. So it's been a couple days, I've spent some time testing out the Kinect and Brekel Body, and I wanted to share some of my final thoughts. Brekel Body is great. It was stable, it ran quick, it was efficient, and I always got good quality FBX animations out of it. There's actually some really interesting features that Brekel Body has that I didn't really get into in this video, like the ability to save a video file directly from the Kinect's feed, or the ability to use networking to sync multiple copies of Brekel Body up together and do, you know, remote trigger on another computer for recording. Additionally, for game developers, there's actually a way to link Brekel Body into something like Unity or Unreal Engine for live retargeting. One question people might ask in the comments section is, why did I choose to use version 1 of Brekel Body instead of a newer version? Brekel Body actually has two newer versions. There's version 2 and version 3. Version 2 of Brekel Body only supports the Xbox One Kinect, so because I'm using a 360 Kinect, I couldn't use it. Version 3, however, is currently in beta, and it supports not only the 360 and Xbox One Kinect, but other sensors as well, including webcams. I didn't use this version, however, because when I was trying it out, I ran into some issues importing my FBX files into Blender that came out of Brekel Body version 3. Because I'm kind of on a schedule for this video, I didn't have time to look into it a little further and really dig into the issue, so I just chose to fall back to version 1 instead. It could have been user error on my part, but if not, the software's still in beta, it's still in active development, so I'm sure it'll improve over time. As for the Kinect, it was mostly fine. One thing that I did not mention in the beginning of this video is that installing the SDK properly was a hassle. I commonly ran into issues getting my Kinect to properly initialize and be detected on my system. And I had to spend some time uninstalling software, fiddling in Device Manager, and playing with cords to get it to work properly. I did figure it out eventually, and to be fair to the Kinect, I have not ran into an issue since then, but I figured it was important to note. For someone who's maybe expecting a plug-and-play situation here, you might have to do a little more than that to get this working. As for the limitations with the Kinect that I listed before, yes, they are annoying to deal with, but you do kind of get used to it after a certain point, and you understand what type of motions that you make are gonna look good on the Kinect and aren't gonna look good on the Kinect. Now, one thing I might actually try in the future is two-person recording, because the Kinect is capable of tracking two different people at the same time. Rokoko was surprisingly where I had the most trouble. And again, I'm not sure if it's something I just need to research and learn how to use a little bit more, or if perhaps the armature skeletons that Omen and all the other characters I tested aren't really optimized for retargeting, but it was difficult to get good results. I noticed that jittering was much more noticeable on the retargeted armature than that appeared directly from within Brekel. There was also some weird drift in bones I noticed in the animations from retargeting. Like for example here, where you can see Omen's head and crotch kind of shift back and forth. I don't know what's going on there. That wasn't in the original recording. If anyone has any more tips to share with getting Rokoko to work, please leave them in the comments section below, because I'm gonna have to do a lot more research on this plugin. Despite all of this, however, overall, I'm very happy. It's not a perfect setup by any means, but it works. And it's helped me advance my knowledge with Blender. If you have an older Kinect lying around from when you played on Xbox 360 or maybe even the Xbox One, I would maybe consider giving Brekel Body a try. There is a free trial available for all three versions of the software, and you can find the download link to it in the description below. I hope you all found this video informative and interesting. If you did, you can help me out a lot by liking the video and subscribing for more content in the future. Thanks for watching.